Hey everyone, this is Brennan. Today I'm going to show you how to create a 3D computer model of a thread spool in Blender. If you've never used Blender before or have very minimal experience using it, don't worry, this tutorial is for you. I try to break everything I do down in this tutorial into its most basic steps. After I've gone over things that are repeated a few times though, I do simplify down the steps. Feel free to follow along with me as I go and let me know in the comments how it works out for you. I decided to do a video tutorial of how to create a 3D computer model of a spool because I have a lot of wooden spools that used to belong to my great-grandmother. Recently I've gotten into thread spinning, specifically I've been spinning cotton, and I look at these spools on my desk all day and I was wondering, I wonder if anybody's created any tutorial on how to create a spool in Blender. Surprisingly, when I searched Google and YouTube, I didn't find anything. So the spool we'll create today won't have any thread on it, it'll just be a basic wooden spool. And it will be a solid color without any texture. And that should keep things nice and simple. Let's get started. All right, so I've just installed Blender here. If you haven't installed Blender on your computer already, you'll need to go to www.blender.org and download it for free there, and then install it on your computer. There are a few things I like to change when I've just installed Blender before I create anything. And these are two options that will allow us to navigate around in this 3D view here a lot easier, and it will also make the controls more similar no matter if you're using a Windows, Mac, or Linux machine. To do that real quick, let's come up at the upper left-hand corner of the screen and click on Edit, and then let's click on Preferences. When this Preferences window comes up, click on Input, then click on both Emulate Numpad and Emulate 3-Button Mouse. You can then click Save Preferences, and then close the window. Now let's test the controls real quick before we start making our thread spool. If you scroll the mouse wheel up and down, you'll notice that the view zooms in and out. If you hold the Alt key down on the keyboard and click and hold down the left mouse button and drag the mouse at the same time, you can rotate around in the view. If you hold down both Alt and Shift on the keyboard and press down on the mouse and drag the mouse around at the same time, you'll notice you can pan the view around. If these controls are too difficult for you, you can also use the buttons on the side of the screen. You can just press and click down on this magnifying glass and drag the mouse in and out to zoom, or you can press and click down on this hand icon and just move the mouse while doing so, and that will pan the view around. One last thing that I think is important to remember before we begin creating our thread spool is that anytime you make a mistake in Blender, you can undo or go back on that mistake just like you would in any other computer program. You can do so by clicking on Edit at the upper left-hand corner of the screen and then clicking on Undo, or by pressing the shortcut on your keyboard, Control and Z at the same time. All right, so the first thing we're going to do to create our thread spool is we're going to delete everything that's already in this scene. Let's press the A key on the keyboard once, then press the X key on the keyboard, and when it says OK, delete on the screen, let's just click the mouse on delete or press enter on the keyboard, and you'll notice it deletes those three objects. Now we're going to create a basic circle, and we're going to turn that circle into our thread spool. Up here at the left-hand corner of the screen, towards the top, let's click on Add, then let's click on Mesh, then let's click on Circle. You'll notice a circle's been added, if you zoom in, to the middle of the screen here. Now press the Tab key on your keyboard, and that will activate Edit mode. You'll notice all these points appear along the circle. This mode allows us to edit the shape and basically change it into anything we want. So first we're going to make a flat donut kind of shape. Let's press the E key on the keyboard, which is for Extrude, and then press Enter. Though you can't see it, that created a second circle that's actually connected to the first one. Now let's press S on the keyboard, which is for Scale, and then just move your mouse, and you'll notice that this donut shape starts to be created. I'm going to drag it to about there. That will be the middle of our spool, and then I'm going to press Enter on the keyboard to confirm. You can also click your mouse to confirm that. Now I'm going to press the A key on the keyboard to select everything. Then I'm going to press the E key, which is for Extrude, and then I'm just going to move my mouse upward until I have a nice tall cylinder shape. When your cylinder looks similar to mine, just click the mouse or press the Enter key on the keyboard to confirm. Now, if you hold down the Alt key and click down on the mouse and drag the mouse around, you'll notice that we have this basic cylinder shape with a hole in the middle of it. Now we're going to make the midsection indent on our spool. Over at the left side of the screen, there's a few buttons. This button that looks like a cube with a vertical line going through it is the loop cut button. Let's click that, and then when you hover the mouse over the middle of your cylinder, you'll see a yellow line appear. Just click the mouse once. That will create a loop cut or a ring around the center of our cylinder. Now, let's click this little arrow at the lower left-hand side of the screen next to where it says loop cut and slide. This will give us a few more options here. And where it says number of cuts, one, click in the box where it says one, and then type in two on your keyboard and press enter. You'll notice we now have two of these rings at the middle of our cylinder. One more thing to check before moving on is that you have the number 0.000 right here next to factor. If this number says anything else, just click in this box and type in zero. That ensures that our midsection stays perfectly centered on our cylinder. Now, let's come to the upper left corner of the screen and click on this select box cursor. Now, let's press the S key on the keyboard for scale and just move your mouse in and out. You'll notice that the midsection on the cylinder shrinks and expands. I'm going to shrink it to about right there, then click the mouse to confirm. Now, let's press the S key on the keyboard again, and then press the Z key on the keyboard. That will make it so I can only scale up and down along the Z axis. I'm going to scale this midsection to about right here, then I'm going to click the mouse to confirm. We now have a pretty basic spool shape created. So now let's press the Tab key on the keyboard to exit edit mode. But you'll notice that we have all of these lines going through the shape. And if you zoom in, you'll also notice that the edges are pretty jagged and not exactly round. We're going to fix that real quick. The right side of the screen, let's click on this wrench icon. Then click on the Add Modifier button. And then click Subdivision Surface. This basically rounds everything out on your model. You notice that it looks pretty distorted now, but don't worry, we'll fix that in just a moment. By where it says Levels View, if you hover your mouse, you'll notice that there's some arrows next to this number. I'm going to click this arrow and change the number to 4. And then next to Render, I'm going to do the same thing. You'll notice that our model is now a lot smoother. Be careful of turning these numbers up too high though, because they can really slow your computer down. Now, let's come up to where it says Object and click on that, and then let's click on Shade Smooth. You'll notice we now have a very smooth model. I'm going to fix the distortion that happened a few steps ago now. Let's press the Tab key on the keyboard to go back into edit mode. And then let's click on this triangle with 3 points over here at the right, just to snap everything back into place. Now press the A key on the keyboard twice quickly to deselect everything. And then rotate the view upward. We're going to select this ring right around the center here. Press the C key on the keyboard to activate circle select mode. You'll notice a circle is now around my cursor. If you move the mouse scroll wheel up and down, you'll notice the circle gets larger and smaller. I'm going to set it to about this size. Now I'm going to click down on the mouse while dragging the mouse to select this ring. Then I'm going to right-click on the mouse to exit circle select mode. Now let's click up here towards the top of the screen on the edge button, then let's click on edge crease, then let's press the number 1 on the keyboard, then let's press enter. You'll notice that is now back where it should be. Press the A key twice on your keyboard again quickly to deselect everything. Now we're going to do the same thing we just did to this ring. Press C on your keyboard to activate the circle select mode, then just click and drag your mouse to select the points on this loop. Be sure to right-click on your mouse to exit circle select mode before rotating the view. Otherwise, holding down Alt and clicking and dragging will actually deselect points. Once you have this ring selected, go ahead and click on Edge again, and then click on Edge Crease, then press the 1 key on your keyboard, and then press Enter on your keyboard. Now press A twice on your keyboard again to deselect everything, and then press C on the keyboard to activate circle select mode, and then click and drag, we're just going to select this top ring. And then we're going to click on Edge, and then click Edge Crease, then the number 1 on our keyboard, and then press Enter. Alright, starting to look like it should again now. I'm just going to repeat those steps that we just did on the bottom portion now. I'm going to select everything with the circle select tool that you press C to activate on the keyboard. Then I'm going to go to Edge, click Edge Crease, press the number 1, then press Enter. And then again. Now, when you get to this last one on the bottom, be careful, because when you select, you might accidentally select some of these other points on the inside. Those are actually the points on the top. If you do this, go into your circle select mode, hold the Alt key, and then click and drag the mouse to deselect those points. Once you have just this ring selected, go ahead and set the edge crease like we've done previously on the other rings. When you're at this point, press the Tab key on your keyboard to exit edit mode. You should have a nice spool created. The last thing we're going to do in this tutorial is we're going to add some color to the spool. Over at the right side, click on this pink circle that kind of looks like it has a checkerboard pattern in the middle. Then click on New, and you'll notice we have material.001. A material is basically what's applied to an object in Blender that allows you to see things like light reflecting off of it, shadows, color, and a few other things. I'm going to click on this white box here next to where it says base color, which should open a color wheel. Then I'm just going to click down with my mouse while dragging the mouse around, and I'm going to drag it right between yellow and red. If I click and drag this bar down on the side, I can change the value of this color between darker and lighter. When you're happy with the color, just move your mouse over back on top of the spool, then press the Z key on your keyboard once, and then click on Material Preview. You'll notice the color is now displayed on your spool. You can do many other things with color, even make this spool look like it's actually made out of wood. That's done through a process called texturing and UV mapping, and I'll be talking about that in my next video tutorial. We've now completed our basic spool. Don't forget to come up to the upper left-hand corner of your screen and click on File, and then click on Save before you exit Blender. Alright everyone, thanks for following along with me. Please like, dislike, comment, or subscribe below. Also, feel free to let me know in the comments what worked for you, what didn't work for you, and what your experience level is using Blender and computers in general. Your feedback and ratings help me make better videos, and I'll take all of your comments to heart. Thanks everyone, see you later.